My dear friends, welcome to Rajashekar classes on data structures through C. This is lecture number 51. In this lecture, we will try to understand merging of two sorted arrays. It is simple. For example, let me take this array 1. All these 5, 8, 22, 30, 36 means these are sorted array, isn't it? This one is sorted array. Again, take one more sorted array. Array 2, 4, 9, 25, 28, 34, 40, 42. This is another sorted array. After merging these two sorted arrays, what am I getting? 4, 5, 8, 9, 22, 25. Means I am arranging all the elements in sorted array. Isn't it? What is the use? What is the application? Where can I find application of merging of two sorted array means? Immediately, I will make use this concept in implementing merge sort in lecture number 53. In future lecture, I will make use it. Now, how can I achieve this one? There are two approaches. First approach is read first sorted array. Again, read second sorted array. Apply any known sorting algorithm. But this approach is not that advisable as it is not taking advantage of sorted arrays. Anyway, I will discuss about second approach. This has got advantage compared to first one. What it is, how it can be implemented. Just see this one. I have first array ARR1. This one is sorted array. Just see. 5, 8, 22, 30, 36, it's sorted array. And another array, 4, 9, 25, 28, 34, 40, 42. How many sorted arrays we have got? We have got two sorted arrays, isn't it? Now, I have to combine these two sorted arrays. How can I combine? Compare first element in ARR1 with first element in ARR2, 5 and 4. Which one is smaller? 4 is smaller than 5. Therefore, these after combining ARR1 and ARR2, I must keep in ARR3. In 5 and 4, 4 is smaller one. That 4 I must keep in ARR3. Now this 4 is completed. Now what are the elements in ARR2? Elements in ARR2 is this one from 9 to 42. Whereas ARR1 elements, all the elements just I copied here. Again, I must apply same logic. How can I apply? Just see, this first element is 5, this first element is 9. Which one is smaller? 5 is smaller. Take that 5 and keep in ARR3. Already 4 is there. Now I must keep 5 here, isn't it? Now what I have to do? Now this array must be copied into next stage here. And this array must also be copied here. Now I must make use same logic. What is the logic? This 8 must be compared with 9. 8 is smaller number. This 8 must be stored in ARR3. How will it be? Just see. Where we stored that 8 in ARR3. Now, what are the contents of ARR1? Here we have 22. Here 9. Which one is smaller? 9 is smaller. Therefore, 9, where can I keep? I must keep here. Therefore, 4, 5, 8, 9. Therefore, these remaining elements will go to the next stage here. What are the elements here? 20, 30, 22, 30, 36 must come here. Again, here first element is 22. Here first element 25. Which one is smaller? 22 is smaller. Therefore, 22 must be here. 4, 5, 8, 9, 22. That's what it says. Now, what happens? That remaining elements. What are the remaining elements? Here 30, 36, 28, 34, 40, 42 will go to the next stage. In next stage, I will take, just see, same story I must repeat here also. Just see, 30 first element, 25 first element. Which one is smaller? 25 is smaller. It will send to the ARR3, isn't it? Now, what happens? This 30, 36 will come here and 28 to 42 will come here. 30 and 28, which one is smaller? 28 is smaller. After 25, you will get 28. What are the elements here? 30, 36, 34 to 34 to 42, isn't it? Now what I have to do? Its logic is simple and straightforward. Again, I must compare first element. This 30 here, 34 here. Which one is smaller? 30 is smaller. Therefore, 30 must store in ARR3, isn't it? Now what we have? 36 here and 34 to 42. And compare 36 and 34. 34 is smaller number, you will get here 4, 5, 30 to 34. This you will have now 36 in ARR1, 40 and 42 in ARR3. Again, I must make you same logic. I must compare first element 36 and 40. Which one is smaller? 36 is smaller. It must send to the, it will be in ARR3. That's what it says. Now, all the elements of first array is completed. Now we have elements only in second array, that is ARR2. That remaining element just blindly copy, that blindly copy into ARR3, so that you will get elements in sorted array. These are the elements in sorted array ARR3. We merged ARR1 and ARR2, and resultant elements we will get in ARR3. These are the elements. These are the elements in ARR3. Anyway, we will try to understand this with the help of program. We will try to implement this logic in next lecture, that is lecture number 52. Thank you very much.